When I got to know about him, I was very fascinated about his life.
He just did what he wanted to do and he did it. Like, it was a one-track mind only.
He had a super active lifestyle.
Cycling, swimming, trekking.
He was with all the time nature and nobody could stop him.
I think he nurtured the love of wildlife in me and love of nature in me.
He was a very good photographer.
Dad was a very powerful leader. He was also a very powerful influencer.
His main thing was educating children.
He shared his love with maximum number of people.
A risk taker and not afraid of anything. And that fearlessness only he had to pay with his life.
Nobody would think that there was an underlying medical condition.
Shankho, we used to call him by love.
Shankho, he vega rasayan hota.
Like, he used to love saying, I'm on top of the world. So he's on top of the world literally right now.
Now my husband, being a forest officer, he used to tell him many stories. And he used to listen wide-eyed.
I didn't know that he had nurtured the sort of love for Nashik, hearing those stories.
And there was a lot of environment, you know, a lot of nature around in Nashik, which he loved. We just decided to pack up and move to Nashik.
And then he started roaming around, going round about Nashik, the places to visit and all that.
मला ट्रेकिंगची आधीपासून आवड होती. मी सगळ्या नाशिकच्या आसपासच्या टेकड्यांमध्ये सगळ्या डोंगरांमध्ये फिरायला जायचो.
So you said that next Sunday we'll go to Kalsubai. So we went to Kalsubai and there I met him on the trek. For first time in life.
आम्ही दोघंच होतो. ऑब्व्हियसली आमचं इंटरॅक्शन झालं, आम्ही बोलायला लागलो. मग तू काय करतो, मी काय करतो.
And it was sort of friendship from the moment we saw each other. There was no great introduction or thinking and like that.
Nantar bareche treks, cycling expeditions, ankin swimming la ami Gangapur la roz asaycho. Kay yog astil maiti nahi. 95 sali Shankho ani mi ekatra alo. And tithun amcha ha pravas suru zala.
And then he started to form this NGO.
And I also told him that we'll get lot of help from government.
So one day I got hold of my car and went to each and everybody, got everybody's signature there, got the proper persons and I got it registered.
हे एक वेगळ्या प्रकारचं काम मला वाटलं नेचर कॉन्झर्वेशनचं. आणि पहिल्याच दिवशी मी शंकोला विचारलं, पण नेमकं काय करणार आहोत. तर तो म्हणे, वी विल I have to save this planet for the future generations. असं त्याचं वाक्य होतं.
He mainly, actually he loved the village children more than our city children. Which actually makes sense because they actually live out there in nature. Our guys don't.
Earlier on, lot of killing of birds used to happen.
The kids here there used to use a catapult. That was a huge threat to the bird population there.
Sometimes it was wanton killing, sometimes it is for food.
Because it was his theory that adults are sort of, in his language, useless. They are not going to change.
It was as if our generation now is lost, basically. We have to do the next generation.
His aim was to reach up to 10 lakh children.
त्याचप्रमाणे जे गंगापूर डॅम आहे तिथे इलिगल मायनिंग व्हायचं, सँड मायनिंग व्हायचं, तिथे बोट क्लब सारख्या ऍक्टिव्हिटीज व्हायच्या किंवा टुरिझम पण वाढत होतं.
फॉर सर्टन हाय फाय पीपल ऑफ बॉम्बे द प्लेन्स विल कम देअर अँड लँड ऑन वॉटर अँड
तिथले जे बर्ड्स आहेत ते डिस्टर्ब व्हायचे.
मोर दॅन लॅक्स बर्ड्स आर सीन बिकॉज इट्स अ इंटरनॅशनल फ्लायवे. बर्ड्स यूज दॅट प्लेस टू माइग्रेट. सो इट्स अ व्हेरी व्हेरी इम्पॉर्टंट हॅबिटॅट.
असे जुने आम्ही मित्र 4-5 जण मिळून रामशेषला नेहमी जायचो. त्यावेळेला नेहमी आमचा विषय व्हायचा की समोरच आहे, जस्ट अपोझिट हा डोंगर आहे बोरगड, पण तो एअरफोर्सच्या मालकीचा आहे. तर आमचा असा या डोंगरात आपल्याला जायला मिळालं पाहिजे. तर जाता येताना लक्षात आलं आमच्या की तिथे ऑलरेडी तिथे जंगल होतं, पण ते सारखं कट होतं. म्हणजे तिथे एवढे एवढेचे स्टंप होते वेगवेगळ्या चांगल्या झाडांचे.
In the initial period, the villagers used to have cattle grazing on that area, and they used to destroy things.
मा असा विचार झाला की येऊन परत याबद्दल काहीतरी करायला पाहिजे. अशी ती ॲक्च्युली बोरगड कॉन्झर्वेशन रिझर्वची आयडिया अशी तिथे जर्मिनेट झाली, पण तिथे अलाउड नव्हतं जायला.
बिसाइड्स द बोरगड ऑर कॉन्झर्वेशन नॅचरल, देन गोईंग टू आदिवासी एरियाज टीचिंग चिल्ड्रन.
तर प्रत्येक झोपडीत यांनी स्लाइड शो करायचा, त्या एका फॅमिलीकरता पक्ष्यांचा. आणि हे पक्षी तुमच्या शेतीकरता कसे उपयोगी आहेत, या सगळ्या निसर्गाकरता कसे उपयोगी आहेत, हे त्या लोकांना तो समजून सांगायचा प्रत्येक घरात.
आणि त्याचाच एक भाग म्हणून त्यांनी तिथे त्यांनी हे विहंग पक्षी म्युझियम स्थापन केलं, आणि जिथे आपण लहान मुलांचे टूर्स ते अरेंज करायचे.
Students of the schools, he formed nature clubs, and
we go to different schools, conduct different activities.
He used to take a lot of camps, drawing competitions, where actively the children will think about it, get involved in it.
We try and give them exciting prizes. The main thing which he has done is recorded the biodiversity in Nashik. So he cited so many different things. So studying on vultures, recording Great Indian Bustard in Ozer, radio collaring wolves. The surprise was to see forest owlet, which is a very, very rare bird.
His main focus was birds throughout his life.
He was a fantastic photographer, and he's collected various images of migratory local birds. This was all compiled and culminated in one book, Birds of Nashik.
नाशिक परिसरामध्ये जे काही पक्षी दिसतात ते सगळ्या पक्ष्यांचे फोटोग्राफ्स आणि त्याची माहिती अशा स्वरूपाचं हे बुक बनवलं, जे इंग्लिश आणि मराठीमध्ये देखील उपलब्ध आहे.
मग मनालीला हे आम्ही सगळं सायकलिंग करून आलो, आल्यानंतर मग त्या दिशेने काम सुरू झालं की बा कोणाला भेटायचं, काय करायचं. लँड फॉरेस्टचं आहे, मग फॉरेस्टवाल्यांना भेटायचं.
लॉट ऑफ पीपल जस्ट सपोर्टेड हिम बिकॉज यू कुड सी द डेडिकेशन इन हिज heart, it was nothing else.
त्याच्यावरती कंट्रोल एअर फोर्स आहे, मग त्यांना भेटायचं.
डॅड वॉज अ व्हेरी पॉवरफुल लीडर, बट ही हॅड व्हेरी स्ट्रॉंग सोशल स्किल्स. सो ही हॅड दॅट ड्राईव्ह टू बेसिकली रीच आउट, टॉक टू एनी वन विदाउट एनी हेजिटेशन, अँड ऑल्सो एक्सप्रेस हिज व्ह्यूज व्हेरी फर्मली.
खाली तुंगलदारा गाव आहे, मग त्या गावकऱ्यांना भेटायचं. मग सर्वात आधी आम्ही काय ठरवलं, इथे आपल्याला प्लांटेशन करायचं. ओके, सगळ्यात आधी आम्ही तुंगलदार गावातल्या गावकऱ्यांच्या ग्रामसभेमध्ये त्यांच्याकडून ठराव पास करून घेतला की निदान ती झाडं कमऱ्या इतक्या वर येईपर्यंत आम्ही तिकडे दूर नेणार नाही.
शंकोने मेजॉरिटी इंडियन प्लांट्स निवडले त्या जंगलाकरता.
लाईक दॅट ही प्लांटेड ऑलमोस्ट विथ हेल्प ऑफ अदर मेंबर्स ऑफ सोसायटी अँड गार्ड्स अँड एव्हरीथिंग. महिंद्रा पीपल यूज टू कम for the actual day plantation.
Shankho is to organize not only local people, lots of people, old and young, along with him. He was not a single visitor. He was always going with a company. That made a sort of, a movement sort of thing.
Almost 1.5 lakh trees were planted like that, and he was not dependent on volunteers totally. Because volunteers means, I may work, I may not work. Meri marzi. So from day one we had a clear idea that we are going to put guards who used to do second duty as watering people also, and it was a very systematic thing.
With the help of forest department, lot of different things were worked on, like the villagers were given gas cylinders, solar panels were installed with the help of our trustee member Dr. Savkar.
Their tendency to cut the forest, cut the trees becomes less, and indirectly the forest gets saved. He used to see that it is watered every day, every tree.
निसर्गाकरता ते काहीही करायला तयार असायचे. सकाळी 5 वाजेपासून रात्री 12 वाजेपर्यंत ते उभे राहायचे रस्त्यात.
फॉर हिम नेचर वॉज द ओनली थिंग दॅट मॅटर, रेस्ट एव्हरीथिंग हिज बिझनेस. इवन
त्याने म्हणजे अल्टिमेटली लास्टली फॅक्टरी सुद्धा बंद केली
आय हॅव्हंट सीन एनीबडी डुईंग दिस. हा म्हणजे रोजीरोटीचा जो असतं अल्टिमेटली आपली ब्रेड अँड बटर, ते आपण सोडू नाही देत कुठे या सोशल वर्क करता.
He felt that he had to devote his entire time to nature because otherwise it was not going to be enough for nature.
And in his work, he probably forgotten everything else.
He had a problem which earlier also was diagnosed by his doctor friends, that he had hypertension, high blood pressure, but he didn't take any tablets, any medicine.
On the third day of his last birthday, went for swimming and he had that cerebral hemorrhage.
I got a call from my wife that uncle has suffered a stroke and he's at Sahyadri Hospital.
I felt so sad and so happy that, see, all the villagers are also coming to bid him goodbye. So I try to be not to be sad, but I miss him so much.
I feel if you are just heeded the advice of his friends or doctors, he would have been today with us.
That's how he's lived his life, and he never listened to anybody. He just did what he thought was right.
He wanted nature. He was with all the time nature, and nobody could stop him. म्हणजे त्याने जर ठरवलं की आता मला आमच्या ठिकाणी जायचं आहे तर जायचं आहे.
तुम्ही त्यांना दुसऱ्या कुठल्या विषयामध्ये बोलायला लागलात तर काही इंटरेस्ट नाही. तुम्ही प्राणी पक्षी वातावरण पर्यावरण या विषयावर बोलायला लागल्यात की मग सुरू होणार गाडी.
आय थिंक ही नर्चर्ड द लव्ह ऑफ वाईल्ड लाईफ इन मी, लव्ह ऑफ नेचर इन मी, विच आय हॅड.
ही टॉट मी अबाउट द रिअल वाईल्ड लाईफ इश्यूज अँड हाऊ माय पॅशन माय इंटरेस्ट कॅन बी कन्व्हर्टेड इन टू सेव्हिंग द स्पीशीज, सेव्हिंग द हॅबिटॅट.
आणि रहा सरांच्याच या प्रेरणेमुळे मला निसर्गाबद्दल अजून ओढ निर्माण झाली आणि त्यातनं आय टर्न माय प्रोफेशन ऑल्सो इन टू वाईल्ड लाईफ बायोलॉजिस्ट.
हिज पर्सनॅलिटी वॉज सच ना दॅट ही हॅज इम्पॅक्टेड सो मेनी लाईव्स.
अँड हिज अवेअरनेस, हिज एफर्ट्स रिझल्टेड इन ऑलमोस्ट 100% एलिमिनेशन ऑफ समथिंग विच वॉज अ पॉप्युलर thing in that entire belt. It's a huge belt, a tribal belt that he has influenced.
So he used to tell them, explain them, it should not be done.
One day when I went with him, I myself collected 80 galols in a single day. You just extend the hand, the boys used to just hand him over. No arguments, nothing.
If you go repeatedly and tell somebody, it does create an impression.
Not afraid of anything. Accordingly, he was fearless.
आणि त्यांनी म्हणजे अगदी ग्रासरूटपासनं ते अगदी हाय लेवलपर्यंत सगळ्यांशी त्यांनी लढायला तयार असायचे केवळ फॉर द कॉज ऑफ नेचर.
ही वॉज ॲब्सोल्युटली अगेन्स्ट दिस बोट क्लब बिझनेस.
तर त्यांनी जो गंगापूर डॅम आहे तो एक इम्पॉर्टंट बर्ड एरिया IBA म्हणून घोषित करण्यामध्येही त्यांचा महत्त्वाचा वाटा होता.
बोरगड हा एक त्याची म्हणजे आपण ज्याला फ्लॅगशिप अचीवमेंट म्हणतो.
इट वॉज अ बॅरन थिंग वेन ही स्टार्टेड.
It's because of Shankho's almost every third day visit or second day visit to Borgad changed the picture. The nature has come back. Nature has taken over again his own area.
And with a lot of conservation efforts, the thing changed and the biodiversity and the bird diversity increased. Now that place has a protected area status. Killing birds, cutting trees is illegal there. So Borgad is the first conservation reserve declared in Maharashtra.
The water table here is significantly high. Higher than most other areas. The farmers are now seeing the benefits.
Now the villagers conduct farming in summer season as well.
It should not end with him. His legacy must continue.
Have to continue educating children, have to continue fighting for birds and animals.
So even if he's not there, a lot of people who admired him are still there and we all have decided to work together.
This is a sort of model which he has created, which we want to continue very actively.
Not only just continue all the projects, but we also expand the scale of work that we are doing.
Try to see that there are many more Rahas, people devoted like him.
Well, during his last moments, we promised him that we will always be a part to Nature Conservation Society of Nashik and always support nature.
This is a win-win story for everybody. And at the center of this story is Shankho.
Like, he used to love saying, I am on top of the world. So he's on top of the world literally right now.